Hi guys, wee Bob here. When I started out on my journey into digital watercolour, I didn't really expect to get the results reflected somewhat similar to real life watercolour painting. I thought it's just not going to be possible. You've got water flowing, you're adding colours, and it's just not something that a computer program can quite mimic with a lot of work happening. But after my previous videos comparing Critter and Sketchbook, I think I might have found a program that has cracked it, or have I? So we'll talk about that in today's video. Today we start at the beginning with what package is this? It is Rebelle. Rebelle 5. Rebelle 5 is a software package that is trying to mimic real life painting with watercolours, oils, acrylics, gouache and other wet and dry media. It is the exact software package that I've been looking for since starting out in digital art journey. I've always been trying to mimic real life traditional painting. It isn't all great news with regards to this software, and I'll get to that a wee bit later. Rebelle was created to provide a unique watercolour simulation, and it was done by an artist called Peter Blaskovich. I've been using it for just over a week now, and I've managed to get some really great results, as I have shown. So let's start with the price. How much does it cost, and how does that compare to the other software packages which I've shown you and that are out there in the market? So this cost me, or is retailed at $150, which is £115 currently. However, during this video, I will explain how you can get up to 20% off that price. So this is $150. This is in comparison to Sketchbook, which is $20, or Critter, which is free. There are other programs such as Ibis Paint, GIMP, Paint.net that are also free. Photoshop, on the other hand, Photoshop costs $26 a month. What, just $26? No, $26 a month forever, which if you add up over a year is $312. Obviously, Photoshop have other packages, but it's just, it's so costly to use Photoshop, and I don't think it's the best, not for doing painting. Somebody said in a comment previously, you're comparing apples with oranges, as Photoshop was never designed as a painting package, and that's fine. But it is used as a painting package by a lot of people, and I don't think it's the best personally. In comparison to real paints though, I did some searching on Amazon, and I estimate that it would cost about £112, or about $85 for a year's worth of watercolour paints, papers, brushes, to get you started, and that hasn't taken into account the fact you're going to have to replace those brushes. There might be other brushes that you need, but I've estimated that it's going to be about $85 to do this in real life. So what does it run on computer wise, this software? Well, I've put up an image of the recommended settings, the minimum settings and the recommended settings. Now I'm going to really recommend that you try and have a computer that matches the recommended settings, and again I'll come back to that. My computer is 10 years old and it runs very well on my computer, but there are some issues which we'll talk about. So what does it do well? The big selling point of this software package over the others is the ability to simulate water. Adding water to the paper, drying the paper, there's actually a water layer that you can bring up and you can see, and you can dry particular parts of it. The paint and the water then interact with the surface of the canvas material, and it's all simulated to show a realistic type simulation of what watercolour would do on a real piece of paper. You can control the tilt of the paper using this little gizmo up in the corner, and you can blow the water around as though you've got a straw. Another great feature in this software is the screen recording. This does sample recording for you. It can do up to 4K and you get to set the sample time. I think I've got it down at 0.1 of a second. You can put it up higher, lower, depending on what you're trying to achieve, and I've put in some of the footage of me having done the screen recording. But with all great things, there's a price to pay, and that is the £110 or the $150. But to get 10% off, just sign up to their newsletter on the website. To get 20% off, you have to tag them in a social media post. There's details on their website, which I'll leave a link to in the description below. This brings the cost of the pro version down to $120, or about £92. The biggest issue is slowdown, and that is what I've experienced. in this software. It's not like you can just add water the way you would in real life, add the colour and it flows together, because the real world works like the real world. We're not in the Matrix after all. Yeah, I've got real slowdown if I, for example, one of the drawings I tried to do was about 4 or 5 splodges of blue paint, and I was trying to get them to run together and it didn't quite work. Now, I was running software, I'm running recording software at the same time as recording the screen, at the same time as doing other things like I've got YouTube on. So it could be that it's causing the problem, because my results have been a bit hit and miss. Sometimes the paint runs really well, it runs really fast, and you can control that. There is a little slider that allows you to control the movement of the simulation, speed up, and it is only limited by the computer, or that's what escape motions tell us. So yeah, that's the biggest issue is lag, the biggest issue is performance at this end. My overall view of this software after just a week of using it is that it is superb. You just need to find your workflow. You need to find the way that you're going to use those features, the wet and the dry features, to really work your art. And it is possible, and it does work really well. Obviously, you need the computer. You need a pen tablet of some description, whether it be a monitor tablet or just a basic tablet. If you do want to see my comparison video for Sketchbook versus Krata, there's a video up in the corner. Click that. Cheers for watching, and Wee Bob is out.